Hello children, good morning to you all. Here we are for our next class. I have completed my explanation, not completed, 2 days I have continued with the explanation, which is not over still. Today I am going to teach you or explain the last part of the lesson. First day, location. And what are the Himalayas? What are its three parallel ranges? Their names? How will be the... What is the speciality of all the three ranges, I thought. Then I explained you the states which are located in the Himalayan region. Then I taught you one state, Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir. Yesterday I taught you Uttarakhand, Sikkim, West Bengal. Understand? And Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and West Bengal. Today I am going to teach you the northeastern states. Northeastern states. Understand? I told all the states completed, but one topic is left, that is the northeastern states. So our main topic is India, the Great Himalayas. This is our main topic. Under it, today we are discussing the northeastern states. The northeastern states. Means, we are going to study about the states of which are located in the Himalayan region in the northeastern part of India, extremely northeastern part of India. Just a minute, I will show you the map. You will have an idea about what are the northeastern states. See, if I show you the map, this is north. Understand? These states here, what all you get from right from here, all these states here, small states, they all are northeastern states. They all are northeastern states. They are Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Nagaland, and Meghalaya, Tripura, Mizoram, Manipur. Understand? 7 states are there, children. This is the northeastern part of India. This is east, right? And this is north. So, the direction which is between north and east is called northeastern part. In this northeastern part, which states we are going to study today? Arunachal Pradesh 1, Assam 2, Meghalaya 3, Manipur 4, Mizoram 5, Tripura 6, Meghalaya 7, and one more state. Tripura, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Assam, Nagaland. So, all these states together, we call them seven sisters. Very small states, all of them are. अरुणाचल प्रदेश, असम, नागालैंड, मणिपुर, मिजोरम, त्रिपुरा एंड सिक्किम. ओके, दिस ऑल आर वेरी वेरी स्मॉल स्टेट्स हियर इन द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. दे आर लोकेटेड, दिस ऑल सेवन स्मॉल स्टेट्स इन द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पार्ट, दे आर लोकेटेड इन द हिमालयन रीजन. दे कम अंडर द हिमालयन रीजन. And today we are going to study about them one by one. We are going to study about them one by one. First of all, let us know which states. I'm going to write the names of all the states on the blackboard. Which states come under these northeastern states. Okay. Here, the northeastern part of India, which comes under the Himalayan region, is a group of seven states. Understand? These seven small states, together they are called seven sisters. Understand? People here, they follow their own custom. They speak their own language. Their dressing style is also very different from other states of India. Commonly, other states wear ladies wear sari or Punjabi dress, and men wear pant shirt or lungi, dhoti, kurta, whatever it is. But here, their entirely different dressing style is there. At the same time, even food habit is also different here. Okay, whatever. So these seven states together, we call them seven sisters. What are the states in the northeastern part of India which come under the Great Himalayan region? First one, Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh. Second is Manipur. Third is Mizoram. Fourth is Nagaland. Fifth is Assam. Sixth is Tripura. And seventh is Meghalaya. These are seven states which are in the northeastern part of India, and they come under the Himalayan region. These are the seven states which are located in the Himalayan region. Understand? They are very small states. We are going to study about them one by one. What are they together called? These all seven states together are called seven sisters. Understand? The northeastern states, seven northeastern states, are together called seven sisters. They are very small, and some of their traditions and culture match each other. I understand in this way. These are the seven states of India which are located in the Himalayan region, and they are called seven sisters. Now we are going to study about them one by one, about their capital, climate, crops, ड्रेसिंग ऑफ द पीपल, फूड हैबिट्स ऑफ द पीपल, इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑक्यूपेशन वर्क दे डू फॉर अर्निंग मनी और वॉट इट इज फेमस फॉर एंड वॉट क्रॉप्स आर ग्रोन हियर एवरीथिंग. सो वी हैव टेकन अरुणाचल प्रदेश. अरुणाचल प्रदेश इट इज द लार्जेस्ट स्टेट अमोंग द सेवन सिस्टर्स. अमोंग द सेवन सिस्टर्स अरुणाचल प्रदेश इज द लार्जेस्ट स्टेट आउट ऑफ दिस सेवन. नॉट इन इंडिया, नॉट इन होल इंडिया, ओनली अमोंग द ग्रुप ऑफ सेवन सिस्टर्स अरुणाचल प्रदेश इज द लार्जेस्ट स्टेट. बट इट हैज वेरी लेस पॉपुलेशन. इट्स कैपिटल इज ईटानगर. इट्स कैपिटल इज ईटानगर. अरुणाचल प्रदेश इज द लार्जेस्ट स्टेट अमोंग द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट्स विच आर कॉल्ड सेवन सिस्टर्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज अरुणाचल प्रदेश. इट इज द लार्जेस्ट स्टेट अमोंग ऑल द सेवन एंड इट्स कैपिटल इज ईटानगर. कैपिटल ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश इज ईटानगर. कैपिटल ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश इज ईटानगर. People live in stilt house. What is the speciality of this place? You find stilt house. Do you know what are stilt house? Because this Arunachal Pradesh is full of thick forests. They live in stilt house. What do you know? But now you can find such stilt houses in resorts also. What it is, how the house is built, you know? It is not built of any, what to say, bricks and cement. It is built of wooden planks, wooden boards, cardboards. What is it? Down four poles will be there. Four poles in four corners. On it, house is built. Floor will be made of wooden plank. On it, a house is built. Such house is called stilt house. Such house is called stilt house. When you open your textbook on page number 18, you can see stilt house. Down, it is supported with the poles. Pedda poles toti support chestaru. Kinda four side ankondi, many sides ila poles pettaru stambham laga wooden vi tree trunks. Dan meeda wooden plank chakkalu vesi ఫ్లోర్ చేస్తారు. దాని మీద ఇల్లు కట్టుతారనమాట. ఇల్లు కూడా కట్టెలతోనే కట్టింది ఉంటుంది. సచ్ ఎ హౌస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ స్టిల్ట్ హౌస్. ద రీజన్ వై దిస్ పీపుల్ లివ్ ఇన్ స్టిల్ట్ హౌస్ ఇస్ టు ప్రొటెక్ట్ దెమ్ సెల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద వైల్డ్ అనిమల్స్. దిస్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ దెమ్ ఫ్రమ్ రెయిన్ అండ్ ద వైల్డ్ అనిమల్స్. వై డూ ద పీపుల్ ఇన్ అరుణాచల్ ప్రదేశ్ లివ్ ఇన్ స్టిల్ట్ హౌస్? బికాస్ దీస్ స్టిల్ట్ హౌసెస్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ దెమ్ ఫ్రమ్ హెవీ రెయిన్స్ అండ్ wild animals. So one more speciality of this northeastern states is almost all the northeastern states get heavy rains, very heavy rains. That's why this stilt house protects them from rain and wild animals. Brahmaputra river enters India through this state. Brahmaputra river takes birth in Tibet, actually not in India. It does not originate in India. Whereas Ganga, Yamuna, they originate in the Himalayan mountains of India. Whereas Brahmaputra river, it also originates or takes birth in Himalayas, but not in India. It takes birth in Tibet. From there it starts flowing towards India and it enters India in Arunachal Pradesh. From there it starts flowing and it flows through so other states and it enters West Bengal and then it falls into the Bay of Bengal. Understand? So Brahmaputra river enters India in or through Arunachal Pradesh. Forming and weaving the clothes is the main occupation. Understand? House, they live in stilt house. Understand? Then forming means doing cultivation, growing crops, and weaving. Weaving means making clothes or shawls. These are their occupations. Occupations means I already told you the work which anybody does for earning money, for their meeting their needs, livelihood. This is all about northeastern state, Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal, once again I repeat, Arunachal Pradesh is the largest state among the seven northeastern states of seven sisters. Its capital is Itanagar. It has very less population because it is completely hilly region, full of mountains. And people here live in stilt houses to protect themselves from rain and wild animals. Then Brahmaputra River enters India through this state. This is all about Arunachal Pradesh. We are going to study about second state now. Second state is Manipur. Manipur. Imphal is the capital of Manipur. Imphal. I am writing to the side. This is the state, this is the capital. Imphal is the capital of Manipur. Understand? Here, farming is main occupation of the people. People engage themselves in farming and weaving. This line, by mistake I taught you just now about Arunachal Pradesh. But it is about this. Manipur, capital is Imphal. People engage themselves in farming and weaving to earn money to meet other needs. They make beautiful articles through bamboo. Handicraft is also famous here. Handicrafts means the artistic things which are made with hand. Bamboo handicraft. They make beautiful articles. Articles means things with bamboo. And cane and leather. Bamboo, cane and leather. Manipur dance is popular. Understand? Manipuri dance is very popular dance form of India. In India, there are so many dance forms you find. Bhangra from Punjab, Lavani from Maharashtra, Mohiniyattam from Kerala, Yakshagana from Karnataka, Bharatnatyam from Tamil Nadu, Kuchipudi from Andhra Pradesh, same way Manipuri dance from Manipur. It is very very famous dance form among the dance forms of India. It is one of the classical dances of India. Understand, this is all the very simple things, small things we are going to study. Once again I repeat, Manipur is the second state among the seven northeastern states. Its capital is Imphal. People's main occupation is farming and weaving. And moreover, here people make beautiful articles or things using bamboo, cane and leather. Understand? And Manipuri dance is one of the most famous classical dance forms of India. Manipuri dance is one of the most famous classical dances of our country. Then next week we are going to study about Meghalaya. Third one is Meghalaya. थर्ड वन इज मेघालय. वेरी स्मॉल स्मॉल स्टेट्स लाइक अवर हैदराबाद मुंबई वन सिटी दैट इज देयर एरिया आई कैन से. शिलोंग इज द कैपिटल. कैपिटल ऑफ मेघालय इज शिलोंग. सो शिलोंग इज द कैपिटल ऑफ मेघालय. मेघालय मीनिंग, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मेघालय? मेघ मीन्स क्लाउड्स, आलय मीन्स होम आर अबोर्ड. सो मेघालय मीन्स अबोर्ड ऑफ क्लाउड्स. मीनिंग ऑफ मेघालय, मेघालय मीन्स अबोर्ड ऑफ क्लाउड्स. मेघालय मीन्स अबोर्ड ऑफ क्लाउड्स. हिमालय मीन्स अबोर्ड ऑफ स्नो, हाउ होम ऑफ स्नो. वेर एज मेघालय अबोर्ड ऑफ क्लाउड्स, इट इज फुल ऑफ क्लाउड्स थ्रू आउट द ईयर. एंड यू नो इट इज वन ऑफ इट्स प्लेसेस कॉल्ड माउसिन रॉम रिसीव द हाइएस्ट रेनफॉल इन इंडिया इन द वर्ल्ड. माउसिन रॉम इन मेघालय रिसीव्स the highest rainfall in the whole world. Naturally Meghalaya always clouds cover the sky here. Understand? People here are tribal people. I already told Garo, Khasi and Jaintia tribes live here. And in one more state Sikkim also we find three different types of tribal people, Lepcha, Nepali and Bhutia, these three. In the same way, in Meghalaya also we find tribal people only. They are Garo, Khasi and Jaintia. These are the names of the hills which are located in the state of Meghalaya. By this name they got the tribe's name also, Garo, Khasi and Jaintia. People here do farming again. Farming is the common occupation of all the seven states of these northeastern states of India. Farming is common occupation of the all the seven states in the northeastern part of our country. What do they grow? They grow rice, jute, potatoes, sugarcane, pineapple and oranges. They grow fruits, sugarcane, potato, juice and rice. So naturally rice is the staple food, main food item. Even in our state Telangana also rice is the main food item. Along with rice we eat curries, dal, curd etc. Is it not? So the main food item which we consume every day, it is called staple food. So here also Manipur rice. What do they grow? Rice, potatoes, grapes, pineapples and jute. Understand, oranges. This is all about Meghalaya. Next we'll go to the fourth state, Mizoram. Fourth state is Mizoram. Mizoram is the state and its capital is Aizawl. Aizawl is the capital of Mizoram. Understand? And here people speak English. They, most of them can read English in this state. Whereas you go to other states, only the people who are staying in city or educated people only can read English. But not all the people together. Understand? So, Mizoram is the land of hilly people, tribal people again, okay. Aizawl is the capital. agriculture is the main occupation. I already told, farming is the common occupation of all the people in all the 7 northeastern states. They can read and write. That is their specialty. Next, we are going to Nagaland. 5th one, we are studying about Nagaland. Nagaland capital is Kohima. Kohima is the capital of Nagaland. People of Nagaland are called Nagas, as people of India are called Indians. Same way, people of Nagaland, Nagas, Mizoram, Mizos, like that. Here also, farming again is the main occupation. People grow millets, rice, maize, oranges. Rice, millets, maize and oranges are the main food items grown here. The Nagas wear shawls of different designs. Naga people are accustomed to exposing their traditional culture of shawls. Naga people are very famous in even making the shawls of different designs, and they wear the shawls of different design. They are very fond of showing their shawls. Next comes Assam. Dispur is the capital of Assam. Understand? River Brahmaputra has made Assam very fertile. Assam is one of the fertile lands of India because of delta or silt brought by the river Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra is one of the biggest rivers of our country after Ganga. Because of this river, it is a perennial river which never dries. Because of this river, Assam is the most fertile land. Again, farming is the main work of the people here. They grow rice and jute. And Assam tea. Assam is famous for the production of tea. World's highest production comes from this place. Highest good quality of tea is grown here on the slopes of the mountains. Guwahati is the largest city in Assam. After Dispur, Guwahati is one more city here. People here speak Assami language and they celebrate the festival called Bihu, as we celebrate Ugadi, Dasara and all. Here people have their festival called Bihu. Then Tripura, the last state is Tripura. Seventh among the 7 sisters is Tripura. Understand? Agartala is its capital. Agartala is the capital of Tripura. Here also again, farming is the main occupation. People grow rice and jute here. Bamboo is also grown here, and even bamboo is used in their food items also. It is used to make handicraft items. So along with farming, handicraft of bamboo is also famous here. So these almost all these 7 states, right from Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Mizoram, Assam, Manipur and lastly Tripura. All these states, what common features we find? One is every state does farming. Second, they all are located in the hilly region. Third thing is all the states experience very cold climate. Understand? Most of them have their variety of dressing sense and variety of food habits. So, this hilly region has many hill stations. So, people visit these places during summer and enjoy the scenic beauty here. So, this is all about the explanation of the lesson, the Great Himalayas, India, the Great Himalayas. We have completed the explanation of the northeastern states, their capitals, what do they grow, etc. So, here we stop today. Let us continue tomorrow. Thank you.